The American Southwest is known for its wicked heat, relentless sun, and unforgiving desert terrain. What many don't realize is that the mountain ranges provide a refuge for incredible wildlife species. We are headed up into the Chiricahuas to explore its rich biodiversity and to see which ants can be found higher up in elevation.
The high desert is home to an incredible array of plant and animal species, and the ants certainly do not disappoint. The region is dominated by Pogono Myrmex harvester ants, which are specially adapted to handle the soaring daytime temperatures. They fan out from their nests, collecting every seed they can find in their short expeditions. The ants here are impressive, and next episode we'll return at night to see what species cooler temperatures bring about. But for now, we're heading into the canyon. The winding road brings us into the first new ecosystem, which is punctuated by rugged cliffs and sparse oak woodlands.
This region serves as a mecca for biologists from around the world, and it has hundreds of unique reptile, bird, and mammal species. We are here at the American Museum of Natural History's Southwestern Research Station, which hosts wildlife enthusiasts, researchers, and natural history field courses, such as the Ants of the Southwest class. Unfortunately, the station is closed for pretty obvious reasons, but luckily for us, there are over 350 known ant species in Arizona, and we're going to begin our search for them in these woodlands.
We just found this wonderfully beautiful Pseudomyrmex Apache queen walking on this dead piece of wood here. Pseudomyrmex are what we call arboreal ants. They live up in the trees, usually in dead limbs. But this queen clearly is scouting out a place to start a new colony. And this is something we absolutely want to bring back to the studio. And I'm going to try and catch her in this vial, but Pseudomyrmex are really fast and they're notoriously difficult to collect. Pseudomyrmex are elongated twig ants, and they use that slender body to fit into small wood cavities where they establish their nests. This is just like the Tetraponera that we found in Madagascar. These ants also have incredible eyesight, and they can actually track you as you walk around their home tree. But be careful, because they have a seriously powerful sting.
Pseudomyrmex often start their colonies in small chambers or crevices they find in trees. Like carpenter ants, twig ants are able to expand these chambers if they are in a soft medium. Here we see a large colony expanding its nest within a standing tree. Not far away, we stumble on some truly unique ants.
Oh, this is very exciting. We found Trachymyrmex. Now, these are fungus-growing ants. They are related to the true leaf-cutting ants like Atta and Acromyrmex, but they're a little different. They focus on other forms of detritus and organic material to grow their fungus garden on. Wow, they're just special ants to find out here. Trachymyrmex have an incredibly distinctive look to them. They really look different than any of the other ants out here, and they definitely walk differently too. Because it's very warm out right now, most of the colony is down deeper, but we do see some workers here in the tunnels. Trachymyrmex are fairly small ants, especially compared to the monster Atta colonies of the Amazon rainforest. What's also great about Trachymyrmex is that they don't have soldiers, so you can handle them without being worried about getting bitten by big, big quarter-inch soldiers that'll actually draw blood. They're basically a seriously miniature version of the larger fungus-growing and leaf-cutting ants that we've all come to know and love through nature documentaries. Trachymyrmex can often be identified by the way in which they put the soil around rocks where they're nesting, and this looks like a pretty good spot to check for them, because we do have that excavated soil like through here, and it's at the base of a tree, and we often find trachys down by the base of trees. So I'm going to carefully pull this rock away and see if we can find any. So what we found instead is a colony of Monomorium. Now, these are some of the smallest ants here in this forest and really in the whole state of Arizona. It looks to me as though maybe they are inhabiting an old tracheal myrmex nest because there's still a similar tunnel structure to an active one. Our journey up the mountain has brought us to this wonderful rain-fed stream. Streams like this exist all along the Sky Island Mountains only during the monsoon season, and they bring much needed water to the plants and animals of this region.
This water provides a rich habitat for moisture-loving insects we would never have found down below, and it's clearly an oasis for many of these species. This is emblematic of how so much of Arizona's environments don't match up with people's expectations. What a wonderful way to end our first day of exploration. Tomorrow, we'll see which ants we can find at the highest reaches of the Chiricahuas.
Below are fed by moisture that's collected up here at the peaks of the Sky Islands. That moisture also creates a really interesting environment, and when paired with elevation, it's very similar to Montana. We've got pine trees, ferns, and even some awesome wild raspberries here. Let's see what ants are up at the highest elevations. Just come across an Amazon ant colony in the middle of a raid. What they're doing is they have found a formica nest and they're going in and taking pupae from that nest to raise as their own slave workers. These ants are absolute obligate slave makers, meaning that they can't even take care of themselves. They rely on the formica slaves to do all of the work in the colony. The formica aren't even fighting back, they're just completely confused and overrun by the slave makers. We're just down the ridge from where we saw the polyergus raiding the formica colony, and I have uncovered another formica colony. This appears to be the same species that were under attack up there. They've got some brood distributed under the rock, but judging by how few workers have responded to what is pretty much a giant emergency to the ants, it's probably not a very big colony, maybe with just a single queen. Well, I haven't found many ants on this hill, but over here under this rock, I found a really awesome mole cricket. Now, this is a pretty good example of an insect that I wouldn't be likely to find over in Montana. These mole crickets are subterranean, and it's been pretty awesome to see an animal like this. Whoa! Especially such a large insect here at the top of the mountain. I'm going to make sure that it goes back in its burrow and we're going to continue on our way. Well, there's some foraging termites down here. You can tell the soldiers apart from the workers because of the bright orange heads and their really strong black mandibles. There's only four here, so I'm pretty sure this is just a foraging party and the main colony is somewhere else on this hillside. Oh, cool! So. Right next to the termites, we've got a Solenopsis colony. They bring pupae under the rock to warm them, which actually speeds up their development. You can see there's a major trail here, and then the queen is probably somewhere down there, about 3 inches down in the soil. Thief ants are pretty interesting ants because they live near other ant colonies of different species and they steal from them. So they'll go in and they'll take their brood, they'll take their food, and bring it back to their colony. What's great about them is that they are indicators that other ant species should be nearby. Oh! Okay, so we've got a Fidoli colony right here. Fidoli are really easy to recognize in the field because they have large major workers, which have really big heads. They're super distinctive. We don't see Fidoli in the mountains in Montana, but we do have them along our rivers. It's kind of interesting to see these Fidoli so high up.
The diversity of life here is astounding, and it's the reason I fell in love with the Chiricahuas many years ago. As we conclude our journey, the final ants we find may just be the prettiest of all.
We were just wrapping up our expedition today, and I decided to walk down this ridge and flip a couple more rocks before we left. And right over here is a fantastic Camponotus colony. They're really beautiful ants. Here we have a couple of majors underneath the rock and some minors accompanying them. You can tell they're majors because they have the big, strong mandibles and the large heads. And in this species, they definitely have brighter coloration, which is pretty interesting. So we've uncovered another section of this Camponotus nest, and here we've got the winged elates. These are the queens and the males right here. This means that they haven't dispersed for their nuptial flights yet, which is pretty interesting given the time of year that we're looking at them. There's also some callows running around, and the callows are the light-colored workers that have newly eclosed. Basically, that means that they've hatched out from being pupae, so they're kind of newborn ants. It's pretty awesome to see this ant up here. It's a species I don't recognize, and that's always an exciting thing to find. The Chiricahuas are part of a network of mountains called the Sky Islands, which lie at the confluence of the Chihuahuan and Sonoran deserts. To our north are the Rocky Mountains, and to the south are the Sierra Madres. All of these factors influence the biology of the region, and has allowed it to become one of the most biodiverse hotspots in North America. As we've seen from the desert flats through the oak woodlands and up here in the pine forests, ants are thriving here, but it may not always be so. This area is thought to be even more vulnerable than much of the planet to factors like climate change and habitat loss. And in the future, I hope that we'll be better stewards of the Earth. Thanks for watching.
Next time on the Ant Explorer.
I was really, really hoping that we would come across a colony.
The immigration inspection guys, you guys are U.S. citizens, I'm guessing you guys are snake hunters?
Whoa.
Two.